Some have sneered at this work of reform and have said it was all unnecessary, that it was an excitement to divert minds from present truth. They have said that matters were being carried to extremes. Such do not know what they are talking about. Foodborne disease may be responsible for 5,000 deaths, 325,000 hospitalizations, and 76 million cases of gastrointestinal illness each year in the U.S., according to a report released by officials from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. While men and women professing godliness are diseased from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet, while their physical, mental, and moral energies are enfeebled through gratification of depraved appetite and excessive labor, how can they weigh the evidences of truth and comprehend the requirements of God? Some are indulging lustful appetite which wars against the soul and is a constant hindrance to their spiritual advancement. 1 Timothy 4:87. First Corinthians 9:24. Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run, that ye may obtain. And let us run with patience the race that is set before us.
According as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. To knowledge, temperance, and to temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness, and to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity.
Meat eating is doing its work, for the meat is diseased. We may not long be able to use even milk. The liability to take disease is increased tenfold by meat eating. The sarcoma tumors that develop are the most common malignant tumor found in cattle. About 1% of the cattle shipped to market in California are condemned due to BLV. This amounts to roughly 5,200 cows per year. The numbers being condemned is increasing and is three times that noted in the 1970s. Keep in mind that when a lymphosarcoma is found in any location, the cow must be condemned. The health reform is a part of the third angel's message, and is just as closely connected with it as are the arm and hand with the human body. I saw that we as a people must make an advance move in this great work. Ministers and people must act in concert. God's people are not prepared for the loud cry of the third angel. In order to be fitted for translation, the people of God must know themselves. They must understand in regard to their own physical frames, that they may be able with the psalmist to exclaim, "I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made." Are we waiting for the coming of the Lord? They have a work to do for themselves which they should not leave for God to do for them. He has left this work for them to do. It is an individual work, one cannot do it for another.
Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God.
We all should ever have the appetite in subjection to the moral and intellectual organs. The body should be servant to the mind, and not the mind to the body. 1 Timothy 4:86. The sin of intemperate eating, eating too frequently, too much, and of rich, unwholesome food, destroys the healthy action of the digestive organs, affects the brain, and perverts the judgment, preventing rational, calm, healthy thinking and acting. And this is a fruitful source of church trials. 1 Timothy 6:18. How can those who are seeking to become pure and holy that they may have the companionship in heavenly angels, take the life of God's creatures that they may consume the flesh? CDF 380.
Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life. They that are Christ's have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts.
But by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Lord doth man live.
For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace, and not of evil, to give you an expected end.
Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. And beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge.
When we are enlightened by the Spirit of God, we shall behold only the seeing nothing but deformity in ourselves, we shall fix our eyes in faith upon Jesus. And as we contemplate the beauty of Christ's character, we become transformed into the divine likeness. The Lord has let his light shine upon us in these last days, that the gloom and darkness which have been gathering in past generations because of sinful indulgence, might in some degree be dispelled, and that the train of evils which have resulted because of intemperate eating and drinking, might be lessened.
Chapter 55. Ho, everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters, and he that hath no money, come ye, buy and eat. Yea, come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Wherefore do ye spend money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which satisfieth not? Hearken diligently unto me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness. Incline your ear and come unto me. Hear, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David.